coming in at 5.5 inches or 14 centimeters for both. Boba Fett Tython and Fennec Shand are what we're looking at today. I just reviewed these guys as well, if you want to check them out on the channel, Migs Mayfield and the Stormtrooper Jedi Patrol, and I thought they were the absolute winners of this wave. And whilst they are in many ways, the Bobas and the Fennec, actually, they're pretty awesome too. I really didn't expect much from them. They're a lot better, perhaps, than I thought they were. Let's take a look and we shall show you a little bit more. So Fennec, straight away, has the green packaging for her. Ming-Na Wen on being a great actress on just about every comic cult show out there. Number one in the Book of Boba Fett. And there's a bit of text if you want to freeze frame for her. Great art on the packaging, really, really good and very lifelike indeed. So, yep, nice kind of soft, subtle green tone going on there, kind of Boba-esque. And she is looking superb, really, really good. If we just take a quick look, first of all, at this weapon that she's got. Huge kind of piece there, and lots of kind of detail on it. Let's zoom in just to see a little bit more on this sniper rifle. Very much hers. No real paint or weathering on it, but it's nicely done. We've got a kind of soft little plastic kind of ball joint in there, which is kind of nicely done, which allows it some flexibility to go over a shoulder, which is kind of nice. We don't get to see that kind of detail sometimes, but yeah, that's potentially one that could snap, so be careful with that. She's wearing her helmet here in this shot, but we'll take that off shortly in a minute. But some nice weathering on that, I thought was really nicely done, that kind of metallic bottom of the visor with some silver going on, the little grill pieces there, and some weathering on the top of the helmet, which is pretty nice. Hasbro don't often do that. And she's pretty detailed throughout the rest of that sculpt, and there's a lot of work as usual has went into the sculpt, all that fabric and on the boots, even the buckles the way they've got, even the underside peg holes, and yeah, little touches of orange on her. Again, even all this intricate patterning and the folds, beautifully done, really nicely put together. Look at all the detail in that armband, or on the entire arm, I should say. And even the back is just like, wow, lots of very nice details. And her hair even has some weathering too in that braid. Little buttons and badges, and even just on the chest plate there, that kind of pattern continues on, and then that darker plastic, the way they've done it, it's just a really nice contrast between, you can really see it on the shoulder, the two different styles, and just under the helmet as well, they've got that pattern going on. So again, just to notice the sculpt, it's very detailed. Popping off the helmet, a little bit tight, but still, it's a removable helmet. It's looking pretty much like her. I think the eyebrows could have possibly been a little darker, which is why it's looking a little bit white there and a little bit pale, but we've got some really nice detail on the scar and on the face, and it's most definitely hard. Lovely detail on the hair too, great sculpt, braid, that one single strand of hair down on the face, which is, yep, not movable, good, it's all one piece. It's a nice little touch. It's beautifully done. Solid, solid figure, and again, removable helmet if you want to pop one off. There's a little bit of give in that, so you have to kind of bend it down a little bit to get her eyes to show through it. But yeah, solid, solid figure. Now, in terms of articulation on her, ball joint on the top of that head. She has a ball joint up her shoulders, pinless tech at the elbows, single joint there. Wrists are both usual swivel and back and forth. You can see that join there. Underneath this, we've kind of we've got a pretty reasonably good upper body swivel. It looks like she's got a waist swivel, but no, it's not. Pins up at the top of the legs, usual stuff. Down to a thigh cut, double joints, or sorry, my apologies, single joint to the knees. No boot cut, and rocking ankles. Solid figure, really like her, really good, really quite impressed with this figure. So Ming-Na Wen, aka Fennec Shand, is cool. Just again, the eyebrows kind of freak me out. They should have been darker, I think, shouldn't they? Must need to watch the show. Anyway, there we go. So Ming-Na Wen is there. Now this figure, again, arguably what most people want to see. Boba Fett Tython, his first appearance in The Mandalorian. I was kind of, when I saw these pictures, I thought, you know what, it's kind of sweaty fetty in a in a cape, meh, kind of not really into it. Where's his armor? It just wasn't really kind of exciting me too much. And then I got it in hand. And hopefully if I can show you some detail on this as well, you will like it too. By the way, picked all of these up at darksidetoys.com. Link to buy it from them in the description below. They are, like a lot of things with Hasbro, Hasbro are shipping out piecemeal. They're not giving everybody their full allocation. So again, they're probably getting cases in randomly from Hasbro when Hasbro can get them off docks and across shipping. So if you've not got yours yet, that doesn't necessarily, I get any special treatment. I did know it because other people got it too. So yeah, it's a case of just, as soon as they get stopped, they get it in. But they've certainly got them up for pre-order and maybe getting them in, I'm sure, more as I speak. So, number 16 in the Mandalorian line, and again, some great artwork and some text on the back. So, the figure, again, I wasn't too enamoured with at first. I thought, it's just not going to work. The pictures didn't do it justice. Let me zoom in a little bit, I'll show you a little bit more detail. So, we've got some really nice sculpting of Tim Morrison there. It's absolutely him, without a doubt. They've got all these kind of veins and sarlacc structures going on in his face. And they've added in this white paint to accentuate the scars across his face, which kind of works. I think it's really pretty good. The issue is obviously, it's a small issue, but the issue is that the kind of plastic leaves him to be very shiny and almost a little bit translucent looking across the face. And don't get me wrong, Tython is a hot looking planet, even though they wear capes. But still, it just looks a little bit shiny, but I think that can be rectified. A little bit of black kind of Gundam marker just to kind of dab that down slightly might make a difference, but still a solid face. Definitely Tim Morrison, definitely got some facial scan tech going on there, and it's really nice. It's pretty good. Facial sculpt was good, but and don't get me wrong, it is very good, but it was the rest of this, the cape particularly. Now, normally Hasbro tells us that a lot of these things with soft goods, oh, that requires this to be an exclusive, and really? Because this screams like it would be an exclusive in many ways, and it's not, it's in the main line. But we get some really, really nice sculpting on this figure. Let me take the gaffy stick out of his hands for a moment, just to show you a little bit more. We got this awesome sculpt underneath the robe. So we've got this kind of ribbed upper piece, and there's very, the good, the bad, and the ugly bandolier across the waist, or cummerbund with bullets, if you want to call it that. And we get a pistol too, we'll show you that in a second. And these flaps, always about the flaps, kind of underneath the wraps that he's wearing and down to the boots. But it's just such a nice figure underneath. I thought, I want to display this more. And then the fact he's got a working holster too, but it poses really well, and it just looks really good once you get it all working on the right way. So there's the blaster. Looks really good, really solid, I'm liking that. And again, working holster, whoops, pop that in there, but that just looks awesome. Let me zoom out a little bit more, there we go. And he just, again, it all kind of comes together. Once you get this cape, which actually behaves really well because there's tons of it, there's absolutely tons of fabric underneath that, but if I also take off this weapon here, which is kind of holding down some of the fluff from the neck, whoops, you can see this Tusken rifle. And what's nicely engineered is this moves. So they've allowed this to be, well, taken off if you wanted, which gives you that flexibility. But if you wanted to put it over one arm, or you wanted to put it over that way, or this is a really nice touch. A nice piece of engineering by Hasbro to allow that flexibility across whatever shoulder or way you want to have it displayed. If he was holding upside down, then the cord hangs down the right way, so that gives it that extra kind of dimension, which I think is really, really nice. Works really well. Gaffy stick is looking pretty good. Not a lot of detail at this end, whoops. But still looks quite nice. Obviously we get to see that in the recent episodes. And we get some really nice sculpting again on the stick. All that beautiful sculpting is there. This looks as if it comes apart. I don't know whether it does, but mine was not wanting to come apart. And the pointy end down there with some gold paint, a little bit chip, but yep. And this, again, a string which allows it to be put over his shoulder should you want. So you get plenty of flexibility on that department. And given he has got so much stuff on him, this huge ass cape, which again, nice little touch, They even painted the belt at the back in gold, and they normally would scrimp on that and not bother. So it feels like a lot of love went into this because it's Boba, so I'm pretty impressed. Now, you could have him like so, and I just think he'd be really, really boring and look really kind of, I'm a monk, boring. But it just allows you to kind of give a bit more posability to him and just show some of this great, his MC Hammer pants off underneath here. It's just really nicely done. I just didn't realise there was so much detail underneath and thought it's going to be a boring figure. Now, you can put the hood up, and with a lot of faffing, probably to get it look a little better, but yeah, I hate soft goods like that when it comes to the neck. So it takes a little bit of futzing around, and you do have this collar up here, which helps really kind of force the piece around the neck to display it properly and really let the neck kind of show properly. You know what I'm talking about with soft goods, it's always a bit of a nightmare. But that just works really well and just poses. It's just one of those figures. You think it looks different, and then when you get it in hand, it's really pretty damn cool. So we've even got some nice sculpting underneath Boba's shrouds and these cool red gloves. I don't know what's going on there, but they just look really, really good. Holds weapons good, got a lot of flexibility and movement. In terms of articulation, he's got a ball joint on that head. It looks like he's got a neck joint in there too, so we've got, yes, plenty of wobble. We've got underneath, you can just about see inside there. It's not really a butterfly joint, I think. I don't know, I can't really see. I think it might be actually a little tiny one inside there. But you then have, see that kind of armor that goes across it? So I think it's inside but then hidden. You've got a ball, don't know why, because it's under a cape, but you've then got the ball joint at the top of that arm. There is no bicep swivel. It's single joint at the elbows, which is a reasonable angle. You've got swivel on the wrist and back and forth, as you can see there. Really nice, given the cummerbund and that band that goes all the way around, which is soft and kind of flexible, but attached to it, you get quite a range of movement. So it means it moves as he moves. So, you know, given all the robes and all the stuff, that's not too shabby at all. I don't know how it's fixed up there or not, or I guess it's not fixed, it's just rotating or floating over the rest of the figure. Again, under these flaps, you can see we have the peg joints. We also have a thigh swivel. We have, under the MC Hammer pants, this single join here. You can see big, huge, unusual knees, but beautifully managed and designed. From an engineering point of view, I think they've done a really good job on this. You also get a boot swivel, and rocking ankles, and peckles. Bull was a hit, man. I'm very impressed with him. I thought he was not going to be what he was going to be, but he really stands out. Both of them are excellent figures, and just, yeah, can't wait for the rest of them. Really, really good job by Hasbro. Love to nail this sweaty issue a little bit, but apart from that, I think they look really good. So check them out and let us know what you think. Leave a note in the comments. Again, link to buy it, Dark Side Toys, there's a link underneath the description, and yeah, tons more coming from them and me. See you soon. Bye.